We have a very special visitor today, and in the 15 years I've been caring for bats, there you go, this is the first one I've had in care. And Bec, who's holding this little tubie, who doesn't have a name yet, she's an eastern tube nose bat, she's not a micro bat, she's a flying fox. What was the story, Bec?
She was unfortunately stuck on some barbed wire fencing.
You want some more, darling?
And the people who own the home had only just bought it, so they hadn't had a chance to remove the fencing yet, but I believe they've already taken care of it. They had covered her up for us with a towel to reduce her stress and just keep her as calm as possible while we tried to get there, because it is very wet weather here at the moment. So we required a pickup from the person who'd called her in to come and get us and take us to her. And when we got there, we thought we were attending a flying fox of normal Brisbane species, so probably a black or a grey. And Mel was with me and she pulled the tail back and we discovered it was not what we were expecting at all.
Nobody expected this, did we? We were all a bit, just overwhelmed, really. It's just such a privilege to have such an incredibly exquisite animal in care.
Yes, she's gorgeous.
She's got some damage. But we're confident that she'll be able to go home, and she will go home and she'll be released back to the place that she came from. And she was in a guava tree, wasn't she, Bec?
Yeah, she was near a guava. I think they said pineapple guava, but either way, it's those little guavas, not the big ones.
I think it was a cherry, but it's irrelevant anyway.
Yeah, but it was just heavy with fruit, really heavy, and the barbed wire passed through the middle of it, so it was a bit of a trap.
Well, she won't touch guava, because the people gave us some guavas, and I've tried guava today. She won't touch it. Just give her a little foot of support. Yeah.
Nope.
It's got a gloves on.
There you go.
And anyway, Bec's very kindly brought over some custard apples. And this is the first time she's shown any interest in eating fruit, so she's been on a semi-liquid diet up until this point. So I just want to say a huge shout-out to the people who found her, who are taking the barbed wire down, to Bec and Mel for having a very exciting Sunday, and especially for giving me the privilege of raising, but caring for this incredible little animal. She's, we've got a bit to learn about you, but I've got a very good mentor in Far North Queensland who's been very helpful. So we'll get on with her custard app and we'll see how we go. And the other thing is, she's an adult girl, so she's probably pregnant. So we've got to really look after her carefully. And we will. And we'll have a name soon.